Two Republican lawmakers are asking the Food and Drug Administration for documents that might prove that the president is politicizing the vaccine process and the possible need for booster shots for political gain. Joining us now for more is one of those two Republicans, ranking member of the House Oversight Committee, Kentucky Congressman James Comer is with us. Congressman, good morning. Nice to see you again.
Great to be back on your show.
Congressman, you sent a letter to the FDA expressing a whole lot of concern that the White House was pressuring FDA officials to recommend these booster shots by September 20th. Now, we know that two FDA officials have already resigned. Tell us what's going on here and why the administration, particularly Joe Biden, would want to do something like this.
Well, that's what we're trying to find out. Steve Scalise and I are probing this. You take the FDA, doesn't even have an FDA commissioner. Joe Biden's been in office for 8 months. He has never nominated an FDA commissioner. So what he has over there are a bunch of career bureaucrats that it appears he's trying to strong arm on this booster shot issue. A normal president would have had a press conference on a decision as important as recommending booster shots and answered questions. He would have been surrounded by health experts, by his medical team, but Joe Biden didn't. He just unilaterally required the FDA to recommend booster shots against many of the career FDA bureaucrats' advice. So this is very concerning. One would think this is an effort by Joe Biden to defer the attention off his debacle in Afghanistan and all the other problems he has, but
right. That's
what we're trying to find out.
It's fascinating, and this didn't happen when Donald Trump was commander-in-chief, but for the first time, really, the CDC, the FDA, and the administration are all on separate pages when it comes, especially to the booster shot. But I want to know where you are on these vaccine mandates. You know, if you look at the Constitution, which I know that you are an expert, this is something that should be up to the states. And there is no mention, members of Congress don't have to be vaccinated. Teachers in New York City protested last night the vaccine mandates. 60% of the African-American community nationwide remains unvaccinated. Why weren't things like that and all of these migrants who continue to cross the border, why wasn't that brought up last week when the president addressed these new mandates?
That's a great question. You know, every American that I've spoken with regard to vaccine mandates, has expressed concern that our border's wide open and all these people are flowing across the border. Joe Biden doesn't require them to be vaccinated. They're not even testing a lot of these people before they move them into sanctuary cities all over the U.S. So Joe Biden's just making the whole vaccination issue worse. I am strongly opposed to mandates for vaccines. I don't think whether they be federal employees, whether they be our military, whether they be any American citizen should be required by the government to take the vaccination. And one reason that we have so many people unvaccinated is because of all the lack of consistency coming out of the Biden administration, dating back to when Joe Biden and Kamala Harris were running against Donald Trump, and they
right.
said they wouldn't be vaccinated if Donald Trump told them to be vaccinated. So we've got a problem with the messaging coming out of the White House.
Yes.
That's why Scalise and I are doing this letter, because we fear that this decision was made purely on political reasons.
You brought up a good point. I want to play you a soundbite. This is Dr. Fauci and House Speaker Nancy Pelosi talking about the vaccines and whether or not there will ever be mandates. Take a listen.
I don't think you'll ever see a mandating of vaccine, particularly for the general public. Sometimes in the health sector, like in my hospital here at NIH, you're not going to be allowed to go on the ward unless you get a flu vaccine. But you would never mandate, at least I do not think you would. I'd be pretty surprised if you mandated it for any element of the general public.
So here's the thing. We cannot require someone to be vaccinated. That's just not what we can do. It is a matter of privacy to know who is or who isn't.
Congressman, just about 30 seconds. What's changed?
I think what's changed is the Democrat poll numbers are plummeting. Biden, Fauci, and Pelosi have all said previously that we would not require vaccine mandates. Now, because of political turmoil facing the Democrat Party, they've changed. That's why we want to see the communication between the FDA and the Biden administration on what gave them the basis for this decision to require boosters and recommend booster shots.
My goodness. All right. Keep us posted, please, Congressman. We appreciate you bringing this to light. Without this, I don't think a lot of people would know about what's going on right now. So we appreciate that. Congressman James Comer, thank you.